Okay, review the solution problem one again. Most of those pages are just supporting computations in order to arrive at the final amounts in the worksheet. So I hope you will study all those for your benefit. Okay. I am going to proceed to problem number six, straight problem. I also gave to you this problem for your assignment, so I'm going to take up this. Davis Incorporated acquired a controlling interest of 80% of Martin Incorporated for $300,000 January 1, 2004. When Martin's common stock and retained earnings were carried at $180,000 and $60,000 respectively. On that date, Martin's book values approximated its fair market values, with the exception of the company's inventories and the patent held by Martin. The patent, which had an estimated remaining useful life of 10 years, had a market value which was 20,000 pesos higher than its book value. Martin's inventories on January 1, 2004 were estimated to have a fair value that was 16,000 higher than their book values. For 2004, Davies' net income from own operations amounted to 100,000 and dividends declared 30,000. It was predicted that Martin's goodwill impairment test, which was to be conducted on December 31, 2005, would result in a loss equal to 10% of the goodwill, regardless of the amount at the date of acquisition being recorded. During 2004, Martin reported a net income of 60,000 and paid 12,000 in dividends. Martin's 2005 net income and dividends were 72,000 and 15,000 respectively. Martin uses straight line amortization for all its assets. Davies Incorporated retained earnings on December 1, 2005 were 80,000. For 2005, Davies' net income from own operations amounted to 120,000 and dividends declared 40,000. Compute the following. One, non-controlling interest in profit for 2004 and 2005. Two, consolidated profit attributable to PEN shareholders for 2004 and 2005. Consolidated retained earnings at December 31, 2005. Non-controlling interest on December 31, 2005. Goodwill balance on December 31, 2004 and 2005. Consolidated patents at December 31, 2005. First, let's compute for the non-controlling interest in profit for 2004 and 2005. Non-controlling interest in profit for 2004 amounted to 8,400 and in 2005 it's 12,020. Okay, so how did we get the non-controlling interest for 2004 in the amount of 8,400? Okay, now take note. I am answering this. It's not posted in the Canvas, so I hope you will follow. Requirement number one. Consolidated net income for 2004. Net income from own operations. We have the parent Davies Company. Net income from own operations. The parent Okay, Davis Company, 100,000. Subsidiary, Martin Company, the amount of 60,000. So the total is 160,000. Less non-controlling interest in net income. Less non-controlling interest in net income. Okay, we have the amount of 8,400. And amortization of allocated excess by 18,000. Goodwill impairment, zero. So I'll repeat, less non-controlling interest in net income, 8,400. Amortization of allocated excess, 18,000. Zero ang goodwill impairment. So the total is 26,400 to be deducted from 160,000. So the difference between 160,000 and 26,400 is 133,600. That's the controlling interest in consolidated net income or profit attributable to equity holders of parent. So controlling interest in consolidated net income or profit attributable to equity holders of parent, 133,600. We add non-controlling interest in net income. Non-controlling interest in net income, 8,400. So the consolidated net income for 20X4 is 142,000. Consolidated net income for 20X4, 142,000. Okay, so double rule, 142,000. Next, net income of subsidiary in 20X4, 60,000. Net income of subsidiary in 20X4, 60,000. We deduct amortization of allocated excess in 20X4. Amortization of allocated excess in 20X4. The sum of 2,000 plus 16,000. The sum of 2,000 and 16,000. So the total of 18,000. 60,000 minus 18,000. The difference is 42,000. We multiply this by 20%. So the result is 8,400. That's the non-controlling interest. Non-controlling interest in net income. Okay? Assuming that there is no non-controlling interest on impairment loss. So the non-controlling interest in net income is 8,400. Okay? So how did we get the amortization of allocated excess? The amortization of allocated excess, if we use the partial goodwill approach, is computed as the fair value of subsidiary is equal to consideration transferred, 300,000. And then we deduct the carrying amount of Martin's net assets. The carrying amount of Martin's net assets is equal to the common stock of Martin, 180,000 times 80% is 144,000. 144,000. That's the common stock of Martin. since the ownership interest is only up to 80%. So only 80%. Now, how much is the retained earnings of Martin? Given in the problem is the retained earnings of Martin equal to 60,000. You multiply that by 80%, so you get 48,000. Okay? So the common shares of Martin, 144,000 and 48,000. That's the retained earnings of Martin. So the total of 192,000. That's the carrying amount of Martin's net assets. 300,000 minus 192,000. The difference is 108,000. That is the allocated excess on January 1, 2004. So 300,000 minus 192,000 is 108,000. From this, we are going to deduct the over or the undervaluation of assets and liabilities. So we now have increase in inventory, 16,000 times 80%. Increase in inventory, 16,000 times 80% is 12,800. And we have increase in patents, 20,000 times 80% or 16,000. The total of the undervaluation of assets and liabilities, 28,800. We deduct from 108,000, the difference is 79,200. That 79,200 is the positive excess. The positive excess, or we have the goodwill using partial approach. Okay, 79,200. Now, second, we have the full goodwill approach. In the full goodwill approach, we are going to begin with the fair value of subsidiary, 300,000 divided by 80%. Fair value of subsidiary, 300,000 divided by 80%. The consideration transferred is 375,000. From 375,000, we are going to deduct the carrying amount of Martin's net assets. The common ordinary shares, Martin, 180,000 times 100%. So 180,000. And then retained earnings, 60,000 times 100%, 60,000. Adding 180,000 and 60,000, we get 240,000. Okay? So 240,000 deducted from 375,000. The difference is 135,000. That is the allocated excess on January 1, 2004. The allocated excess on January 1, 2004. Okay, then we have 135,000. We are going to deduct the over or the undervaluation of assets and liabilities. So we have increase in inventory, 16,000 times 100% equals 16,000. And then for the positive goodwill, or I mean for the increase in patents, 20,000 times 100%. So we get 20,000. The total is 36,000. We deduct from 135,000. So the difference is 99,000. That is your positive excess. Or we have now your goodwill partial. Positive excess. Or we have the goodwill. Okay, we have the positive excess. Goodwill, okay, but this time my goodwill here is full goodwill, no? So full goodwill, not partial. The amount of 99,000. 99,000. Okay, now a summary of depreciation and amortization adjustments is given for these patents and the inventory. Now, anyway, I'll try to post the solution to problem 6, no? After this, so at least you'll be guided accordingly. So, for requirement number 1, the non-controlling interest. Requirements 2 up to number 6. So, anyway, I'll just post this in the Canvas together with the solutions to problem 1. But for the meantime, let me give you the solutions to the multiple choice problems. Okay, na? This one I am not going to post in the Canvas. Solutions to multiple choice problems. Number 1, boy. Number 2, boy. 3, C. 4, C. 5, A. 6, C. Here, for the multiple choice problems. 6, C. Then we have 7, B. 8, B. B as in boy. 9, dog. 10, dog. 11, boy. 12, boy. 13, dog. 14, dog. 15A, 16 dog, 17 boy, 18 dog, 19 dog, 20A, 21A, 22A, 23A, 24, 25 boy, 26E, 27E, 28, 29, 30, 28, 29, 30 dog, 31A, 32, 2,120,000. 32, 2,120,000. 33, 2,260,000. 2,260,000. 34, boy. 35C. 36C. 37, dog. 38, boy. 39C. 14C, 41 boy, 42C. I just gave you up to number 42. Now, how about the multiple choice theory? The multiple choice theory is only 1 up to number 43. Okay, 1C, 2 and 3 dog. 4 dog yapon, 5 dog, 6 boy, 7C, 8, 9 dog, 10A, 11C, 12 boy, 13 dog, 14, 15C, 16C, 17C, 18, 19 dog, 20 boy, 21 dog, 22A, 23 boy, 24, 25C, 26C, 27 dog, 28C, 29C, 30 boy, 31C, 32 boy, 33C, 34C, 35 dog, 36 dog, 37 boy, 38 boy, 39 C, 40 dog, 41 A, 42 C, 43 A. Now you try to review the answers and ask questions on Monday if you have any questions. Okay? So thank you for staying with me up to 2 o'clock. I hope you will study all these solutions. I will try to post the solution to problem 6. Okay? So any questions? Any questions? Why na? Dai pagya, dai. Kan i-recording, convert na dai. Convert.